Hello guys and welcome to a new video here on my channel. First of all, I want to say sorry that because there was no video last month. I had a lot of stress in my school, then when I finally had time to start filming, I had an accident with my motorbike, which made me unable to do something for a few days. But now that I'm in quarantine because of a corona case in my class, I have enough time to do chemistry. In today's video, I will make elemental bromine. Bromine can be prepared by the oxidation of hydrobromic acid. Hydrobromic acid can be made by reacting a bromide salt with a strong acid. For educational purposes, I dissolved 2 moles of sodium bromide in water. I mixed it with 1 mole of sulfuric acid and then distilled it off. With this step, I probably lost about 50% of my hydrobromic acid. Next, I set up a simple distillation apparatus with a reflux condenser at the end to catch as much bromine as possible. I added in the hydrobromic acid and then manganese dioxide as my oxidizer. From a pressure equalizing funnel, I slowly added in sulfuric acid. The sulfuric acid makes the manganese dioxide give off oxygen. The hydrobromic acid then reacts with the oxygen to form bromine. Because of the big loss in the hydrobromic acid preparation, nearly all the bromine dissolved in the water and a little bit fumed away. I didn't bother to distill that little bit out. A way that gives a much better yield is by performing those two reactions in one. I started by adding 2 moles of sodium bromide and then 1.2 moles of manganese dioxide into a flask, and then dissolving the sodium bromide in water. The flask was then added to the apparatus, and with an addition funnel, about 4 moles of sulfuric acid were slowly added. After 30 minutes, bromine vapors appeared. Later, small droplets of bromine distilled over. The solution was heated and insulated with aluminum foil. After 3 hours, no more bromine came over and the apparatus was disassembled. Because bromine is able to leak out of nearly anything, the only possibility for long-term storage is sealing it into ampoules. I filled 2 small ones about 3/4 full and then added the rest into a big one for my elemental collection. Anything worked fine, until the flask fell over, because of my stupidity. A lot of toxic red bromine gas poured out, but luckily my fume hood was strong enough. And now here we have it, three beautiful ampoules filled with elemental bromine. The bromine is still wet, but that's a problem I will solve when I use it. I hope you liked my video. Bye.